Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. I welcome you in the class. And as we have finished our third lesson, students, we are moving to the fourth lesson, the temperature zones. The temperature zones, TEMPERATURE, temperature zones. As we already know that, and we enjoy different seasons throughout the year. The seasons differ in different places on earth. So we will see here, picnic time, picnic, P-I-C and I say picnic time. Picnic in June, Joy appeared shocked. He was having a telephone chat with his cousin Sid, who lives in Canada. They were discussing Sid's annual school picnic. It is scorching, scorching, S-C-O-R-C-U-H-I-N-G. Scorching means, students, very hot. Scorching hot in June. How could you plan a picnic in that heat? Wouldn't it be more comfortable if you plan something in winter? That is a more pleasant time to be out in the sun. Winters, do you even know how winters are for us? Everything is covered with a thick layer of snow and we cannot even see the sun for days. It is always cloudy, said Sid. Summers, on the other hand, are cool and sunny. Perfect weather for a picnic. We share the same earth and yet the temperatures are so different at two places in the same month, thought Joy. Aloud, I wondered why. So they are discussing about the picnic time. So they are, Sid is going to the picnic in the June month. So Joy said that, how you can go it? Because it is too hot. So they said that, no, it is comfortable in Canada. So we can go it. It is perfect weather for a picnic. So Joy was thinking about that. We are sharing our same earth and how the temperature are so different. So factors affecting climate. What is climate, students? Climate, C-L-I-M-A-T-E, climate. Climate is the average condition of weather over a long period of time. See, the condition of weather which is over a long period of time, that is a climate. Okay, so the climate pattern of different places on earth differs. So the climate is different from different on the different places of the earth. So determine the type of climate, the pattern of rainfall, temperature, wind, humidity over a period of 30 to 35 years is studied by scientists along with the type of landforms and location of the places. So with the on the landforms and the different type of locations, the temperature is also different. The climate is also different. These things affect the climate. The climate of a place affects many things. The kinds of plants and animals living at any place are strongly affected by the climate. The kind of clothes that people wear and even the lifestyle they live, the lead is affected by the climate. So lifestyle means the way in which the person or a group of people live or a work. So now we will see here effects of latitude. See, the latitude of a place determines how much sunlight the place receives. See, the latitude determines, means how much sunlight we are getting, we will determine that. So for example, the frozen area of a green line, see here the green line, the frozen are very cold and dry climate. On the other hand, the tropical rainforest, we are having here tropical area. So of Zaire have a very hot and wet climate throughout the year. So the different in climate is due to the different in the amount of sunlight that the areas are receiving. So Green Line is located at the Arctic Circle. As you can see here we are having the Arctic Circle. So here Green Line is there. So at the latitude of 66.5 degrees north, where Zaire is located at the equator of latitude 0 degrees. So sunlight directly enters in the latitude, so that area is very hot comparing to the Greenland. So here they have been given that why does the amount of sunlight received on earth vary with the latitude. See, it is the curve of the earth's surface that causes the difference. So as we are looking here, figure for intensity of sunlight, these are the picture. So you notice the two land areas in the northern hemisphere. Here X and Y are the two land areas. x at the equator and y near the arctic circle. So that x receive directly and more intense rays, the rays of the sun, it is heated more. So on the other hand, receives less sunlight, slanting rays of the sun, which are not as intense that. So this area of the beam of sunlight at y falls at an angle to this surface, and it was spread over a large area. So as a result, the intensity of sunlight that falls on the land is reduced. So y is much colder than x. Now we will see here latitudes and climatic zones. Based on latitudes, the earth has been divided into three climatic zones. What do you mean by climatic zones? The climatic zones are sometimes called temperature zones also. So each of these zones receive different intensity of sunlight because each is located at a different distance from the equator. Okay. See what they are saying, that at the equator these are the climatic zones. So these are the different, each zone receive different intensity of sunlight because it is located at the different distance. We are having, see, as the Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn is located very near, and the Arctic Circle and Antarctic Circle, it is located very far. So it is at different distance from the equator. They are located at the different distance at the from the equator. That's why they are different climatic zones where they are having. So we will discuss here about the torrid zone. The torrid zone, T-O-R-R-I-D, torrid zone. The torrid zone extends from the Tropic of Cancer to the Tropic of Capricorn. See, these are the torrid zone as we are having here, twins. It is extending from Tropic of Cancer to the Tropic of Capricorn. So, the zone between the equator of the Tropic of Cancer or 23.5 degrees north. Okay, 23.5 degrees north, that is a north torrid. And then 23.5 degrees south. That is south torrid zone. So the torrid zone receives strong sunlight throughout the year. So here the heat causes a lot of evaporations, and here they form the clouds and results in rain. Here this zone receives a lot of rainfall. The climate is therefore very hot, wet and humid in this area, and the day and nights are approximately equal in length between throughout the year. Winters are not very cold near equator. As we move away from the equator, as we are moving from away from the equator and going towards to Tropic of Cancer and Capricorn, the winters become cooler. Now coming to the temperate zone. The temperature zone, temperate zone, temperate, temperate zone, see, extends from the Tropic of Cancer, to the Arctic Circle, Tropic of Capricorn to the Antarctic Circle. So here north side, north temperature, in the south side, south temperate zone. So here the climatic zone is cooler and drier. And there is also a great difference between winter and summer temperatures. And duration of day and light hours changes significantly from season to season. Summer has long days and short night ways. Winter has long nights and short days. Okay. Now coming to the third one, the frigid zone, F-R-I-G-I-D, frigid zone. Frigid zone extends from Antarctic Circle to the North Pole. See, here we are having a frigid zone. It is moving from the Arctic Circle to the North Pole and Antarctic Circle to the South Pole. So North Pole, North frigid zone, South Pole, South frigid zone we are having. Okay, frigid zone, the latitudes are high and the rays of the sun are extremely slanted here. So as they hit the land, so intensity of sunlight received by the earth's surface is very low. So the climate is very cool. There is a continuous daylight for 6 months, followed by the continuous night time lasting six months. Intensity means intensity means strength. So students, till here we will stop, and the continuation will be done in the next video. So I hope you have understood this lesson. Practice the hard work, students. Thank you. Bye-bye.